Kwame, and I'm coming to you live from Kent in the UK today. How are you? I hope you're well and you are good and you're having a very good Wednesday, very good day. I am ish. I've been bogged down with a cold mostly this week, and it's been a little bit tough basically, but I'm getting there. And if you're not feeling too good, I hope you're taking care of yourself. But if you're well, that's good as well. One thing that I thought about sharing is that, sometimes we tend to focus on what isn't right or what isn't working in our lives, and we always tend to forget about what works. So why am I saying that? Because today I watched as the weather, obviously we're in the UK, so we always have some of this we have the weather displaying itself every now and again. And in the morning there was really heavy downpour, and before you would know it, later on in the afternoon there was so much sun. And I'm like, okay, sometimes we look at the weather, like in the morning, and it was very grim, very grayish, not looking nice. And then this afternoon everywhere is bright, it's sunny, it's nice, and it's sweet. And so that's just a word of encouragement that sometimes when you're going through tough times, don't focus on your tough time. Focus on, something else that will come, the good that will come later or after. And that's life. It alternates itself. Sometimes it's good. Sometimes life could be challenging. Let me give a very big shout out here to BJ Yoloye on my Instagram. I hope you're well and you're good. I can't really see anyone on my Facebook, but I hope you guys are well and you're good as well. Today I'm going to be talking about how to get over a breakup, how to overcome that challenge in life. And this is something that majority of people experience in their relationships from time to time. And there are many reasons why people, friendships and relationships come to an end. Basically, it could be that people just grow apart. Sometimes it's about the interests and they don't have the same kind of interest again. That could be one reason. Basically, it also could be that there's certain qualities or elements in the relationship, maybe things like trust, things like loyalty and so on, that should be in the relationship but is no longer in the relationship. And then of course that's another reason why people grow apart. People grow apart as well when there's no effort. What do I mean by that? Sometimes when you're in the same environment, maybe like work colleagues, or maybe you're in the same uni or school with somebody, it's always very easy, or it's easier to stay in touch and stay in touch with them basically. But it could be that you guys have, you've left the same kind of locality or the same area or the same environment, and so that's another reason why people grow apart. But there are many reasons, and it's not about the reason today. It's just to say that what do you do when you're faced with that kind of challenge or that kind of situation in your life? So the first thing for me really is that every change in our relationships, and it doesn't depend, I mean, it doesn't mean matter what the relationship is, but whatever the relationship, any change that happens that brings that relationship or that friendship to an end, stirs up in us some kind of emotions. And so number one thing is actually for us to acknowledge the fact that there's something happening within us, and it's a response apparently to the situation or the circumstance that has just unfolded. And so we should never be in denial. We should never think that, oh, okay, this is just one of those things. And no, because that's the starting point of our ability to be able to handle some of these challenges in our relationship. So when there's a change, maybe somebody moves on, or there's a breakup, or there's whatever, that relationship has come to some kind of end, the first thing is to acknowledge your emotions that follow that action. So that's number one. And of course, like acknowledging your emotions, you are actually saying to yourself, look, listen, I'm human and I'm just responding accordingly to what's on ground and how things are unfolding. So you need to take time, take out time, take out time to find out what is going on within yourself. Take out time to actually find out what is happening in your heart, in your mind, within yourself. You get what I'm saying? That's number one. Don't ever pretend that it's all good, it's all well, you know, I'm fine and everything. And you jolly well might be, but it's more likely that you have been affected by the outcome of, you know, that particular situation. So one other thing that I want to say here is that we have to understand that some friendships, some relationships are here for a season and they are here for a reason, and that not everyone would always be with you for the long term. Some will, some won't. And if you can understand that, then it might be easier for you to approach that situation differently and handle it better when things don't turn out the way that you want it to. So maybe you've had this friendship or relationship or whatever for such a while, and then, you know, things are coming to an end because maybe, I don't know, for some of the reasons that I mentioned and all that. Try to understand that some friendships will be there for you for the long time, but some would not be. And it's all right. It's okay. As long as you can acknowledge and accept that fact, then, you know, you'll be able to handle things better. Now, my number two point is this. Whatever happens, oh, hi, Jumi. Hello, darling. How are you? I'm so sorry. I'm a little bit subdued because I have a cold, nasty, nasty cold. So I'm just recovering. But anyway, I'm getting there. But how are you? Hi, Femi. Wow, good to see you. I hope you're well. I hope the family is well as well. If you're just tuning in, today I'm talking about how to handle a breakup, you know, when things come to an end in any of your relationship or your friendships. And there are many reasons why it would or it can. It happens to all of us, you know. This is the approach. So number one is to acknowledge the emotions that follow. Number two is what I'm going into, which is that whatever happens, there's something that you must never neglect. You must never neglect your well-being. Your well-being is paramount. And there are two sides of your well-being. One is your physical well-being. The second has to do with your mental well-being. Never you abandon or neglect that bit of you or that side of you. If not, you're going to make things worse. Because when relationships or friendships and things like that come to an end, there are usually more negative emotions that are generated within than positive emotions. And so for you to then now add neglect to it, that's neglecting yourself, neglecting your mental state, neglecting, you know, your physical well-being, is actually taking away and not adding anything positive to yourself. So you have to remember that, you know, you can do things like exercise, you can do things like read a very good book, you can, you know, travel if you want to. There are many, many things that you can do that can help you, you know, go through that moment of loss, because it's actually a moment of loss. And when I say, you know, a breakup, I'm not, or a loss in your relationship, it's not necessarily due to death. That is not one of the reasons I'm discussing here, and so on. I'm only talking about when some relationships come to an end because they've just come to an end, you know, somehow, naturally, people moved on, or whatever it is, you've lost the same kind of interests, or one person has grown in the relationship, and so on. But whatever happens, my point number two is you must never neglect yourself. I remember when I had a loss of a relationship. This was many, many years ago, to somebody who was very dear to me that I liked, and they did something very nasty, and I knew that that was the end of that relationship. I couldn't continue that relationship for my own sake. It pained me. But guess what I did? I neglected to take care of myself, and instead of telling on me, because other friends were like, what's wrong? Are you okay? Are you da-da-da-da? And all that. And it took, you know, some good friends around me to slap me, let me put it that way, slap me back into reality, you know. And that's when I learned that this is a very natural process to lose friendships, to lose friends, to lose relationships. Okay, even though I often say that they're gifts, but you know, it's also something that can be lost sometimes due to no fault of yours. And so when it does happen, that's now not the time for you to neglect yourself. It's a very wrong approach, and so you mustn't. Now, my number three point is this. My number three point is that you should find somebody that you can talk to. And these are trusted people, you know. They could be influencers in your life, leaders in your life, people that, you know, you respect their judgments, you respect their, you know, just the way they are and you know, how they do things and so on. And you can confide in them, you can tell them, you know, things that are going on and all of that, you know. And I think we all should have somebody like that in our life. So when things like this happen, talk to such people, okay? Tell them exactly what is happening, and most importantly, learn how to express your emotions about how you're feeling towards this situation that has just happened. Make sure you're able to express it. You bring it all out and you talk to them. But there's somebody else I need you to talk to, and that's to God, because the Lord sees everything, you know. I'm a believer, and I know it's not everybody's cup of tea, but if you believe that you can talk to God and he can hear you, I don't see any reason why you shouldn't include him in that sort of discussion, especially when you have lost a very key relationship or friendship or something like that. So you make sure you open your mouth and you talk to people that, you know, would help you to see things. And you see, the whole point of talking to people is that sometimes we only see things from our own perspective. We don't, you know, when something is happening, our emotions take over, we lose our sense of good judgment and all of that. But it takes another friend, just like it happened to me, to say, come on, you're looking at it this way. How about looking at it from this other angle? And so that's what talking to people, not just anyone, but trusted people, that's what that does, because they help you. And the same thing in talking to God, to see things from a different perspective. And you see, sometimes it's just that perspective that we need. And once we get it, once we see things from that perspective, guess what? We don't feel as bad and we're able to cope with that situation. Hi, Miriam. It's wonderful to have you here. Hope you're good. And how is my little girl? Send her our love. I hope you guys are fine and you're all well. So to my friends on Instagram, to my friends on Facebook, I hope you're well. I started off by saying, forgive my the way I am, because I'm recovering from a cold. I'm a little bit subdued, but I hope you're taking care of yourself, especially those of us who are in cold countries like the UK, the US. Take care of yourself and keep warm. Sometimes these germs are just seasonal and you catch them one way or the other, especially when you have children that come back from school with all sorts of things, regardless. And I also started off by saying that life is always two-sided. This morning it was raining, it was gray, it was, you know, looking not too good. And then in the afternoon there was this beautiful sun that came out, and that's life, two sides. And I want us to look at our relationship and our friendships like that, that sometimes we gain very good friends and sometimes we lose good friends as well. And sometimes it's tough. It's tough sometimes to lose some of those friendships. But what I'm saying is that if we have certain ways of approaching loss of friendships, of relationships, then we'll be able to cope better, basically. So my point number one is that when you have a loss happen, when you lose a friendship, when things happen, gain emotional clarity by acknowledging that your emotions are negative at that time. You're generating those negative emotions simply because you don't feel nice about what has just happened. And that is a natural response. But you have to acknowledge it. You have to. You can't pretend and say, you know what, it happened and, you know, I don't care. Mm-mm. I'm sure you care. But acknowledge it. That's my point number one. My point number two is that whatever happens, never you neglect yourself. Never you neglect your well-being, your mental well-being, and your physical well-being. Take care of yourself. Eat well. Drink well. Hi, Omo. How are you? Good to see you, darling. I hope you're good and you've had a fantastic day today. Drink well. Eat well. You know, things. Nourish yourself. You know, because you have to take care of you. You have to take care of your well-being. And my point number three is that you need to talk. And you need to talk to somebody who is well trusted, somebody who you can pour your heart out to. And if you believe in God, speak to God. So that's what I'm saying. So I can see some people are just tuning in. Today I'm talking about about handling loss of friendships or relationships. Hi Ngozi, hope you're good, hope you're well, and the family's fine as well. Thanks for tuning in. I'm talking about loss of friendship, loss of relationships, because that happens. People are meant to come in for a reason and for a season, and we have to understand that not all friendships are meant to be there. But we also have to understand that if we don't have any particular way of dealing with loss when it happens, and I'm not talking about loss because of death, that's not what I'm talking about. I'm just talking about people who come into your life, they stay for a while, maybe for years, and they leave. Don't neglect yourself. Find people to talk to. Oh, wow, Shade, good to see you. How are you? I hope you're fine and the family is good as well. Thank you so much. I'm proud of you as well. Thank you. So our relationships are ever evolving. Some will remain in our lives for years. I've had friends, you know, very few of them though, that have been in my life for, I can't even remember how many years. Jumi on here, who is watching, she's one of them. And I thank the Lord for people like her. I also have Omo, you know, friends come, friends stay. But some people don't stay, and it is okay. And when they go, my friends, don't despair. Don't despair, because if they're meant to be there, they would stay. But when they go, my point number one is, never you deny your emotions that you're suffering a loss, because it's still a loss. Never you pretend that, you know, let them go. Don't be that, don't talk like that, because every relationship that comes into our lives, whether good or bad, they are still gifts. They are still gifts. But when they go, they go. Yes, fine. We let them go, but we have to still now deal with all of the emotions that has been generated now that this person has gone or left our lives. And so what do? We have to acknowledge what is happening to us. Number two, we have to take care of ourselves. I was saying this story before. I don't know if everybody caught this, but it did happen to me, and it wasn't pleasant, you know. It wasn't pleasant, and I neglected myself, you know. And it took some of my colleagues at the time to slap me back into reality and say, come on, what's going on? You're looking. And I was like, yeah, you know, I'm suffering this and all of that. But it gave me an opportunity, basically, to open up and to share what exactly was going on with me, and I could move on from there. You know, another thing, like I said, is surround yourself with people that still care about you, that still love you, that, you know, will speak good and positive into your own life. And learn to talk to good friends, learn to talk to your God. So yes, not everybody would stay. Some people are not meant to be, like Shade is saying, they are probably not part of your journey, which is true. Be strong and keep on moving, but acknowledge what is going on within yourself, and speak to somebody who is trusted, that can help you see things from a different perspective. So my friends, until next Wednesday, I'm not sure, because I shall be, by God's grace, in Wales for an event. And so if I'm there, it might be very difficult to have my Facebook and Instagram live at 6 p.m. But somehow, I will try and see if I can. And if I can, you guys will see me on here at 6 p.m. Next week, Wednesday. So still stay tuned in. But if I don't then turn up, you know, come on, I will try and post something, you know, something positive for everyone. So something I can share. So stay well, be well, and please don't catch a cold like me. It's just been so rough on me, but I'm getting there and I'm getting better. Love you, Shade. Love you, Miriam. Love you, Jumi and Femi, and all of you that I can't see and I cannot see, and Omar, and who else is on my Instagram? BJ, I think. Yeah, stay well, guys, be well, and remember the most important thing is that you are special, you count, and that even if you lose a friendship, it's not the end of the world. Things happen, but we have to learn how to cope when things don't turn out the way that we want them to turn out. So take care, stay well, and God bless. Bye. I would stop my Instagram and then my